your anarchists don't sound like so-and-so. They say I'm just a stupid kid, another crazy radical. Rock and roll was dead, I probably should have stayed at school. Another generation X who somehow slipped up to the cracks. Oh, they'd love to see me fall, but I'm already on my back. There we go, you want here, and right out the other. People talking shit, but you know I'm never bothered.
Bop Gar and I, back in biz. We're 1.3 in to the old Horseshoe Trail, 150 miles going through Pennsylvania. And we're drinking a Bud Light lemonade. Logical next step.
Logical next step.
Nice house on the Horseshoe Trail. Nice houses on the Horseshoe Trail.
Can't believe they had the money to pave this trail.
Now I know I'm not a saint, I've been a sinner all my life. I ain't trying to have my flaws, I'd rather keep them in the light. They want to criticize, scrutinize, cast another stone. Burn me at the stake and sit and watch it from the throne. They say the devil is my pal. I do a lot of drugs, the crowd will only like me if they're really fucking drunk. They think they know my thoughts, but they don't know the least. If they listen to the words, they find the message type beneath. But it goes to one ear and right out the other. People talking shit even though they never bother. It goes in one ear and right out the other. People talking shit, it can get the back of my head.
Trail's pretty great so far. We're beaving and bopping in and out of the old wood skis, and then you come out on like these million-dollar homes and you just follow the edge of their land. Fucking hilarious.
Here's the moral to the story. We don't do it for the glory, we don't do it for the money, we don't do it for the fame. So all the critics who despise us, go ahead and criticize us. It's your tyranny that drives us as the fire to a flame. And it goes in one ear and right out the other. People talking shit, but you know I never bother. It goes in one ear and right out the other. I'm only playing music cause you know I fucking love it. It goes in one ear and right out the other. People talking shit, it can kiss the back of my hand.
Sitting here outside of old Chester Springs, Pennsylvania, thinking this is probably gonna be the end of day one. We got us a nice 16 miler in, kind of waiting out till the night comes, till the sun goes down, so we can stealth camp. This trail's on a lot of private land, so it's a little difficult to find a place to sleep, but we're thinking this ball diamond will do us just fine. I'm sleeping on that there pitcher's mound. on the old Horseshoe Trail. Me and Botgar, we stayed at a baseball diamond last year for like youth, right? Youth baseball. A little stealth camp action. It was real good. Real good time, you know. Slept, woke up. All of our shit was real wet. Still is wet. We got her packed away. We hiked maybe not even 10th of a mile, you know. Not even 10th of a mile. And then, bam. Hiker rest area. The actual place to camp up. This shit's funny. Nice log splitter there. What else you got? That's a pretty nice fire pit. I'll get the old tire off that old sedan. We're okay, we're okay. On here day two, about 10 miles in, putting us at 26 total. Pretty sweet trail so far. We finally kind of got away from the city and all the road walking and the multi-million dollar houses. I mean, there's still multi-million dollar houses like this one behind me. Thing is giant, probably can't see it, you know. Holy shit, ticks are fucking nuts out here. I've already found four on myself, and Botman's got two on him. So yeah, we keep checking every so often. Yeah, we're gonna keep hiking. We got a little more elevation coming on. And yeah, wild, wild hoagies. And it hurts, not knowing where anyone will go. Give me that rock. That good rock. Wouldn't be a through hike if I didn't ruin a camera. So, first camera down, just crashed the old drone. It was hovering over a river or a stream, and the wind kind of took it, and it didn't stop. Hit the cliff face and went in the water. So, I jumped my ass in there and got that sumbitch. With any luck, I don't break anymore. day three out here on the old Horseshoe trail. Yeah, we stayed at old French Creek State Park last night. Super sweet stealth site, right next to a little stream. We got a big old lake up here. Cooked up some supper up there and waited till the sun went down and then wandered down to the creek. Found a place tucked in the woods. So far, stealth camping hasn't been very difficult, so that's good. It's real fun too. I enjoy that stealth camping. You end up sleeping places that you normally wouldn't. But I mean, I get it. I get the reasons not to and whatnot. You're potentially jeopardizing the future of this trail, or any trail for that matter, by stealth camping. All it takes is one private landowner to get pissed off, and then bye-bye trail. So by all means, on a trail that's got designated camp areas, you want to use those and stay away from the stealth camping and just be smart about how you do it. We've been staying on public lands, I mean like a state park, a public ball diamond and whatnot. So if somebody were to come, you know, they could tell us to get the hell out of there. We ain't pissing off no private landowner.
I'm quick, this I know. Heart's a valve, can I let it flow? Bounding for the end scene, never gonna catch me. I'm chic, let it grow. Strut my stuff to the final show. Grounded from the red dirt, never gonna do work. On a show or get committed, peek out of the box that you were fitted. It all will melt when you live in plastic. You're made of dust and don't forget it. Glow up, grow up, get a mission. Take out the trash and do the dishes. All will pass if you let it go. All will pass.
On them?
Yeah, you can see them. Yeah, those little bastards.
I'm hurt, what'd you do that for? Facing hands on the kitchen floor, cursing everyone whose life is a vacation.
Oh, me and Bob been out here for two whole days. We're getting real feral. We're gonna return to society after this 150-mile hike that's gonna take us probably 5-6 days. We're gonna return to society, changed men. Today's a good day, real good day. Last night, as we sat there like animals and finished off all of our snacks, we got really depressed at the matter. But it's all gonna change today. Whole day and a half, maybe day away from society, and today we're coming up on a gas station. We're gonna get some more snacks, man. Ooh, jalapeno Herd's kettle chips, little beef jerky, Nerds gummy clusters, man. That's what you need. We just ran into a crew of trail maintainers. Got some bad news for old Bot and I, that the gas station with the roller dogs that we had been dreaming of is simply just a gas station that only sells gas. It's a real blow.
I'm surely giving ghost fate, seeing facts who means the most. Man, I gotta give me some of that temptation. Oh.
Back in the fucking woods. Get it out of here. Get it out of here. What's this? Get out of here. Get out of here. Get out of here. Get out of here.
Slap that ass.
Ooh, ooh. Take me to Plowville. Take me to Plowville.
Hey. So much dust comes off.
God. I opened a bag of piss earlier. Hey, yo. Hey, give me a high five.
Hey!
Yeah.
I poked the shit out of you there, didn't I? My bad.
Put that shark on Elijah's positive bus.
Oh, cut. Get you waving.
What are we doing?
I don't know. Dude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a pretty cool car, man.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Till it hurts, man.
Till it hurts.
Till it hurts.
Get it all?
Nope. This one tastes like coleslaw. That's still pickle.
She had a rough day. My baby's physical. She is so Mexico. I'm down begging for more, please. How bad lives in a scrim tease. Rough day, physical. My baby's Mexico. I'm down begging for more, please. Oh, 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 oh. Hey, 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 hey. Mighty time. No, you're mighty time. She had a rough day.
About 7 o'clock right now. We're gonna hike. Apparently there's a lady up here who lets hikers stay in her lawn. It's about 5 miles away. So we're gonna shoot, see if we can get there. And if that don't happen, I guess we'll find a place in the bush. But don't tell anyone. Dude, I saw that. Yeah, I know it's shitting. It was peeing earlier. Dude, this trail is wild.
Faceless terrain in my hands. Clay for farmland. Molding a weight of mass on me. Molten, scorching, groaning. I'm growing.
Good luck, Mr. Turtle. Ladies, we just helped a turtle.
You got some hand sanitizer. I don't want to get salmonella.
Ladies.
Ladies.
Ladies. Yeah, let's see what's in this garbage can. Whoa, dude, it was Miller time up here.
An old Milwaukee and some dog food.
Day 3 of the old Horseshoe Trail. Me and Botgar hiked a good 22, 23 miles yesterday. And we went through some real spooky forests. There was like this fireplace with like some weird ass sculptures engraved into it. Buckets of rocks around it. And we kept walking and there was this abandoned house and the door was open. Yeah, it was spooky. We just went through a thunderstorm too, so like the overcast was on and it was a thick forest and it was real dark. And we come up on a dead deer on the trail where we came out on like this complex, right? It looked like it should be thriving, you know? It was like swings, those little horsey things and like teeter-totters, a merry-go-round. Big old pond with the deepest blue water with a fountain spraying out of it. And it was just all quiet as hell. And then we come across two dead raccoons on the trail. It was a little sketch. Cursed ass woods, we booked it out of there. Yesterday we ran into three trail maintainers. They were giving us like instructions and insight on the trail, and we'd ask a question, right? And they'd be like, "You got the guidebook?" And we haven't been going off the guidebook, you know. We hiked through the night, and there's another person. They were like, "Same thing. You got the guidebook?" It's crazy. All these people, you ask them any question, they're like, "Yeah, the guidebook. You gotta get the guidebook. Get the guidebook, man. You're gonna need the guidebook. Don't mess around. Get that guidebook, right?" They asked us if we had a guidebook, and we're like, "Nah, we ain't get the guidebook." And they're like, "You gotta have a guidebook. You gotta have that sucker." So they went and got us a guidebook. They gave it to us. So now we got the guidebook. So I guess we're safe on this trail now. Got the guidebook.
Shake my bones, but I won't rattle you. Make quay upon me.
Botgar took off because the concerns of the smoke, the Canadian wildfires are blowing away right now, and the smoke's moving in, so he's gonna take off, he's gonna head home, and he's gonna plan on coming back down here and finishing this trail up here in a later date. But I'm a stubborn old man, so sticking it out. We're gonna finish this bastard. Start of day 5 out here on the old Horseshoe Trail. I slept in, didn't have Botman here to wake me up, and my phone died in the middle of the night. Went to bed and I didn't have no water. And I found a spring back here this morning, so I was happy about that. It is fucking smoky, smokier than the Dickens. Apparently the air quality now labeled hazardous, so yeah, I don't know. You know, fucking PCT, I think they go through this shit all the time. But I don't know, man. I've never experienced it. I've been talking to some people that have hiked the PCT. Guess we're gonna give it a go, see what happens, and if I have any trouble, then I can always bail. But it's smoky out right now.
A conception of life, stirring blossoms from their slumber. Beasts will roam and beasts will multiply. Pulse of creation. was born as the world grew heavy. Now a burden, and I am weary. Multi-crescent fires dancing. Why does my treasure try to end me? Whoa.
Fucking power line cut, man. Fucking mile or so stretch. Nothing but tall grass. Holy fuck, man. I'm stopping every once in a while. Like very short distances. And I'm just flicking the damn ticks off, man. I'm at 18 ticks on me so far, just this one section. Oh my god. Holy fuck. Fuck that hellhole, man. It was like a 2 mile stretch, waist high grass. And I pulled 23 fucking ticks off of me, off my legs. Holy fuck, man. There's a lot of things I've dealt with hiking. That might have been the worst time I had. Just knowing all those fucking ticks are gonna get you. Ugh.
Don't know why I've said the same things all my life. I see sunrise.
Take 20, got back on trail, popped into a little town there, Mount. Can't think of it off the top of my head. I think it might be Gredna. Yeah, I said there's a couple restaurants in town. I wanted a burger, so I popped in there. Got a burger and a beer. Sitting there at the bar, and I had two more ticks on me, crawling around. Pulled them off, squashed them. Looked real disgusting in there as a thru hiker. Oh, I'm not sure where I'm gonna camp tonight. Stealth camping is a lot easier when you got two people. It's been many a year since I have slept in the woods all alone. It takes some getting used to again.
Day 6 on the Horseshoe Trail.
Last night sucked. Last night really sucked. Holy shit, I was exhausted, absolutely exhausted. And I haven't been the stealthiest of camper. I'm by myself, right? Man, I'll be honest with you, I'm pretty spooked to sleep in the woods alone anymore. I used to do it, but fuck, man, it's been so long since I've done it, I've lost my touch. I've been staying in like these wide open parking lots, right? This very lot right now, last night, right on over there is where I tried to sleep, and I waited till dark, then I put my mat down and whatnot, and a cop pulls in. And I'm like, fuck, I'm busted, right? So I got up and I went over to the cop car. I thought for sure that they had seen me. And I was like, hey, hiking the Horseshoe Trail. Don't really have a place to stay, whatever. You know, she asked for my ID. I gave her my ID. She's like, yeah, we don't usually let people sleep back here. If your info runs through, fine. And I'll let you do it tonight. And I'll let the guy that does the midnight patrol know and to leave you alone, right? So I'm like, awesome. Hell yeah, I got a secured spot. She runs my shit. She even tells me there's bathrooms across the street. So she leaves. I lay down, man. I lay down. Start hearing noises in the woods, and it's just one thing. It's just one animal. It's a pretty large animal, right? Fucking deer, right? I think it's deer, right? I hope it's deer. I still don't know what it is. It's probably deer. I'd probably just overreacting, right? the fucker starts coming closer to me, right? Starts coming closer to me. Meanwhile, I got my food bag next to me with some fucking stanky ass lunch meat in it, just reeking up the place, right? And I'm just wishing I had my bear line so I could throw it up and hang it like somewhere far away from me. Fucker keeps coming at me, right? So I get up, I shine the light, I see its eyes, I don't see what the fuck it is. I yell a little bit, right? And then I go over there with my trekking poles and I smack them guys together and I chase it off, right? Fuck, runs off, right? And I'm like, all right, I'm good, right? So I'm laying there more. 20 minutes later, I start hearing way in the distance. There comes a big, big motherfucking animal, cracking branches, scuffling leaves, you know? And again, that fucker starts coming towards me. And I'm like, holy shit, is this a deer, right? I don't think a deer would be persistent in coming into the same area over and over again. It gets real fucking close again. Shine my light again, and I get up. I was like, hey, hey! And I smack my poles, and then I get up, and I start chasing the motherfucker, right? Smacking my poles together. Hey, get out of here, you know? And then, you know, it runs off again. Lay down again. Fucking another 20 minutes go by and I start hearing again, fucking twigs are breaking, and again, the motherfucker's coming up on me, keeps coming up on me. Meanwhile, I'm sitting here with this smelly ass meat bag next to me, and I'm like, god damn, is this a deer? Or is this a lot of deer and I'm just in their deer trail? Like, what's going on here, right? And then again, I fucking get up and I start smacking my sticks and I chase the fucker off, and I was like, god damn, man. That's enough of this. So I picked my shit up and I went up the trail back to where I came. There's like a visitor center over here, and I just plopped the shit down right in between two trails. Totally obvious. And you're not supposed to camp there. It's posted up everywhere. It's like midnight at this point, right? I'm just so beat, so fucking exhausted, and I just fucking passed the fuck out, right? And yeah, it was just, ooh, bad night. Then I woke up this morning and I went over to this center they got over here in this park. It's this guy that works there, comes out, Jed, and he starts talking to me. I don't remember if he said like a month ago or whatnot, but there was a car parked at that same spot I was trying to camp at last night, and it was there for 3 days. Eventually, they decided the car was kind of abandoned, so they went out and searched the area, and dude killed himself apparently out here. So yeah, it's spooky. Did he kill himself, or did the bear get him with his big old sweaty meat bag? Or maybe it was the deer that got him.
Under your eyes, but it feels nice to be counted as your vice, and this feels right. Sleep with you at night.
Also wants to go even better. Good speed if you got the power to finish this.
Oh, you're gonna have to skin wait to move us to short bun. That is a good jump. That is a good jump. Oh, that is a very good jump indeed.
Realized I've been shooting everything I've shot today on this camera in slow-mo, so that's pretty cool.
Cause I see figures in my sleep, and a shadow on my wall is beckoning. I fall 10,000 feet or drive until I fall asleep. Don't know why I've said the same things all my life. I see sunrise in the bags under your eyes, but it feels nice to be counted as your vice, and this feels right. Sleep with you at night. I woke twice in the middle of the night and I'd sleep tight. If I had you by my side, can I confide in my sense of touch inside? If you turn slight, you'll see the weakness in my eyes. 'Cause I see figures in my sleep and a shadow on my wall is beckoning. I fall 10,000 feet, but drive until I fall asleep. And the fuel light, it's been on empty all my life, and the sunshine is always blinding both my eyes. It would be nice if I could finally get inside. If I turn right, I'll fall right off this mountainside. 'Cause I see figures in my
sleep. It's a tough climb, man.
And a shadow on my wall is beckoning. Drive until I fall asleep.
Yeah!